Alright, in this video I'm going to prove that the sequence given here is divergent. So there's more than one way to prove that a sequence diverges. One way is to use the definition of how a sequence converges and arrive eventually at a contradiction whereby you can conclude that because the definition of convergence leads to or results in a contradiction, the sequence therefore is divergent. So that's proof by contradiction. A more direct way that I'm going to use in this video is to just use one of the definitions of divergence for a sequence, and that is that if you have two or more subsequences that converge to different values, so say for example the odd numbers converge to negative one whereas the even numbers converge to one, then that sequence by definition is divergent. So let's go ahead and get started with that. So we're going to write proof. We will prove that the sequence xn is equal to negative 1n times n minus 1 over 4n plus 3 diverges by showing two subsequences converge to different values. So if we're going to prove that two subsequences converge to different values, you kind of have to think what subsequences you want to select in your proof. Anytime you have negative 1 to the n, you know that for even values that's going to be 1, and for odd values that value is negative 1. So that's a good place to start thinking about subsequences, and yeah, in this case it does work that if you just look at the even subsequences and the odd, they are different. Sometimes it won't necessarily be odd or even, you might have to do a different type of pair of subsequences. But anyway, let's do the odd and even examples. So for all k in the naturals, then x of 2k, so that would be all even values, is going to be, and then you just plug in 2k into your n for your sequence, so that's going to be negative 1 to the 2k times 2k minus 1 over 4 times 2k plus 3, and then you're going to do 2k plus 1. It could be 2k minus 1, but I usually just do plus 1 the next value over. So that's going to represent any odd value. Actually, this would start, because the naturals start at 1, this would be odd values starting at 3 and up, but it doesn't really matter because you're just going to show that two subsequences diverge. So it doesn't necessarily have to be all the odd values. You don't necessarily have to start at 1. All right, but let's just plug in 2k plus 1. So it's going to be negative 1 to the 2k plus 1 times 2k plus 1 minus 1 over 4 times 2k plus 1 plus 3. So another thing that you have to think about then is how are you going to prove that these subsequences converge? So everything looks a little bit, well, it's not simplified yet, so what you're going to just do is simplify and rearrange the terms as much as you can to be able to take a limit and show that they do converge to a real value. So for that, we're going to simplify that as, so this is always going to be 1, so that just simplifies as 1 times 2k minus 1 over 8k plus 3. So we still can't simplify because we have k in the numerator and the denominator. So what we can do is multiply by 1 over k in the top and bottom, and that gives us 2 minus 1 over k over 8 plus 3 over k. So if you think about it, if you take the limit, 1 over a variable that goes to infinity is going to be 0. And so it's the same thing for the numerator and the denominator. So this will converge to a real value. We don't have to worry about what it is yet. And let's do the same thing for this one. So this is going to simplify to negative 1. Then we have 2k plus 1 minus 1 over 8k plus 4 plus 3. So that's going to be negative 2k minus 2 minus 1 over 8k plus 7. And again, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to multiply by 1 over k and also simplify the values. So negative 2k minus 3, 8k plus 7. And then that equals, if we multiply by 1 over k, that's going to be negative 2 minus 3 over k over 8 plus plus 7 over k. So as you can see, we have different values, and those are going to converge pretty obviously to different numbers. So we have a negative 2 here, and we have a 2 here. All right, so in this next part, you're going to prove that the sequences converge, and we're going to get real values for the limit of x of 2k as k goes to infinity, and x of 2k plus 1 as k goes to infinity. So we have to say three things before we take the limit. We have to say that we know that the limit of 1 over k goes to 0. We just know that from prior lessons. So we can say that we know that the limit, there's a theorem that says that this is true, the limit of 1 over k as k goes to infinity equals to 0. And what we're going to do, because we have a numerator and a denominator for both x of 2k and x of 2k plus 1, we're going to say that because the denominator does not go to 0 in either case, that the limit of the fraction is the limit of the numerator divided by the limit of the denominator, because there are real values in the denominators. So we're going to say that, and we know from algebra that 8 is greater than 0 and 7 is greater than, sorry, 8 is greater than 0. So we're going to just say that we know that this is 0, so these parts are 0. So the limit of the first denominator, 8 plus 3 over k, as k goes to infinity, is greater than 0, and the limit of 8 plus 7 over k as k goes to infinity is greater than 0. Thus, we have that. And now we can take the limits. So we have that the limit of x of 2k as k goes to infinity equals the limit of this first value. So that's 2 minus 1 over k over 8 plus 3 over k as k goes to infinity. We can break this up now into numerator and denominator. And because we know that this is 0, we have that this is equal to 2 over 8. And let's do 2k plus 1 now. So we have that k goes to infinity of x of 2k plus 1, so that's going to be the limit of the second one, again going to infinity. Again, we're breaking that up into numerator and denominator, and that's going to be equal to negative 2 over 8. So we're pretty much done. Now we're just going to say at the end, because obviously 2 over 8 does not equal negative 2 over 8, x of 2k and x of 2k plus 1 do not converge to the same values. Thus, x of n is a divergent sequence because its subsequences do not converge to a single value for all n in the naturals. And we're done.